breaking news. Two people have been killed in a horrific crash on a major Sydney motorway after a police pursuit. For more on this, we're joined by 7 News reporter Angelique Opie at Homebush. Angelique, a major emergency response still ongoing.
Good morning, Nat. That's right. This was a high-speed chase, and as you can see behind me, very much an active scene here. This is where the car ploughed into the embankment, losing control, going down a steep embankment around 20 metres before it burst into flames, both the driver and passenger trapped inside. We know paramedics, fire and rescue crews rushed to the scene, but tragically there wasn't anything that could be done. Both bodies are yet to be formally identified and a critical investigation is now underway. Now here on the M4 westbound lane, westbound traffic is congested. Drivers are being urged to use an alternative route.
Thank you, Angelique. Here's Koshy.
Now, in more breaking news this morning, emergency crews are at the scene of a house fire in Melbourne's north. Let's go live to Sunrise reporter Nathan Curry at Pascoe Vale. Nathan, what do we know?
Well, Koshy, the fires are still hosing down this unit as we speak. I'll jump out of the way so you can check it out. They have managed to contain the fire, but I can still see smoke coming out of the roof of that unit right now. There are so many emergency services crews at the moment, and at this stage we do not know if anyone has actually been inside that unit overnight. So this could be potentially quite bad. I was just speaking to police before, and they say at this stage the house is still too dangerous to try and get inside and pinpoint if anyone was inside. So at this stage, I can tell you it's better news for the neighbours. A lot of the blocks on Rhodes Parade where I am right now have been subdivided into several units. So because of this massive fire at the front unit, the neighbours in the unit behind, they weren't able to leave. They weren't able to get down their driveway to safety. Luckily, because of the work of the fireys, they were able to keep them safe and they're now clear. But we're just still trying to get inside that house to confirm whether anyone was in there or not. And Rhodes Parade, by the looks of it, will be shut for quite a while into the morning, Koshy. So I'll check back in with you soon when hopefully we can deliver some good news about that front unit, but we'll wait and see.
All right, mate. Keep us updated. Thank you.
Let's get more news now. Here's Eddie.
Thank you. Now, Brisbane bus drivers have begun boycotting routes in Premier Annastacia Palaszczuk's electorate after dark following a spike in violent youth crime. For more on this, we're joined by Sunrise correspondent Bianca Stone. Bianca, morning to you. Now, drivers say they're being confronted by gangs of up to 20 youths.
Eddie, good morning. According to the unions, these bus routes in this area of Nala Forest Lake are the most dangerous in the city. They say they're pretty dangerous during the day, but it's at night time when things really ramp up. Drivers are being spat on, they're being abused and threatened. Passengers also feeling threatened, things being thrown at buses as well. It's gotten so bad, the union says, there's been a couple of dozen incidents even since Christmas, and drivers are now boycotting this area at night. According to TransLink, Route 110 will terminate before it gets to Inala Plaza after 6:30 p.m. and Route 100 will terminate before it gets here to the Forest Lake shops. That's leaving locals without reliable public transport in this area after dark, and it's happening in Annastacia Palaszczuk's own electorate. The Premier returned to work yesterday. She faced a barrage of questions about Queensland's ongoing youth crime problem after yet another Queenslander died allegedly at the hands of a teenager.
It's unbelievable that these things are happening, you know, in our state. It is unacceptable in this day and age for people to be losing their lives in such tragic and horrific circumstances. I acknowledge that.
Despite two deaths in just 1 month, the Premier refused to call what's happening here in Queensland a crisis and said she won't recall Parliament early.
Thank you, Bianca. A 19-year-old man has been rushed to hospital after he was seriously injured on the Gold Coast overnight. Emergency crews found the teenager with injuries consistent with a gunshot wound outside a Red Rooster in Helensvale last night.
We've lived in Helensvale for the last, you know, 5-6 years and Gold Coast my whole life. And these last few years, I've never seen this level of crime.
The teen's injuries are not life-threatening. Police are now searching for his attacker, asking anyone who saw a Nissan hatchback in the area at the time to come forward.
Half a million New South Wales drivers could claw back $750 as part of a road toll rebate scheme that's rolling out today. People who spend more than $375 a year on tolls will be able to claim a 40% rebate worth up to $750. Western City drivers are tipped to be the winners in this $500 million scheme, using the state's motorways more than any other area in the city. There are growing calls this morning for rapper Kanye West to be banned from entering Australia. For more, let's go to Sunrise reporter Tegan Dolling in Melbourne. So, Tegan, as we reported yesterday, he's expected to head to Melbourne next week to visit his new in-laws, but this could be a big hiccup.
It could, Eddie. Good morning again to you. They've got a very busy week, Kanye and his Melbourne wife, Bianca Censori, as they bring together their blended families. They were actually snapped last night in Malibu, so they're not here in Melbourne just yet, where they were meeting Kanye's eldest daughter, North. Miss Censori having a very different look. She's got a very short blonde hair now. That's before they are meant to arrive here in Ivanhoe in Melbourne, where they're going to be meeting Miss Censori's parents, Kanye's new in-laws. But he may have a little bit of trouble actually getting into the country, because civil rights academics say that they don't want him in. One actually taking it as far as writing to the federal government this morning opposing his visa, and it's because of his views. He's incredibly controversial. He makes a lot of posts about conspiracy theories on his social media, and because of that, they're saying based on his character, he shouldn't be allowed into the country. But they may have a bit of trouble getting that across the line, because he's coming here for a private matter. He's coming here to visit his new in-laws, and he's not here to make money or to business off of his views. So, Eddie, the federal government have quite a bit of a way to whether they're going to say yay or nay to him coming into the country.
Thank you very much for that, Tegan.